for recognizing you event. Thank you very much, everyone. Now, we proceed to our next agenda, all right? Ito na yung pinakahihintay ng ating mga associates. And now we are 400 plus, no? Kanina nag-500 na, 400 plus. Please be reminded that our training this evening is also live sa ating Facebook account, Facebook, USANA Philippines Facebook. And please invite your associates also. Those who cannot join in sa Zoom call, pwede po nilang ulit-ulitin itong mga trainings natin, which is happening every Tuesday po, every Tuesday, once a week ng ating online business series. And now we are already on our third series, no? Third episode ng ating online business series. And for this week, we are going to focus more on the Leadership 101, right? So let us define what leadership is. Leadership, no, for me, ha, for me, we all have actually a lot of meaning ng ating mga leaders ng leadership. But for me, let me just share how do I define leadership. So for me, leadership was someone who sees how things can be improved, no? So yung mga positive na mga taong nag-uplift sa atin, no? And they are the ones who rally people to move forward towards a better vision. All right. So yun yung aking definition ng leadership. I know all of you, lahat kayo dito, meron kayong definition ng leadership. Kung gusto niyong i-type or i-share sa ating chat box, you can type it in our chat box. You can share it sa ating comment box, sa ating Facebook Live. All right. How do you define leadership? Ayan. So a few announcement po, no. Let me just share with you some announcement, no. Meron din tayong League of Champions and Asia Pacific Growth 2022 Athens Greece Huddle. This is going to happen on August 27. It's going to be a Friday, 1 p.m. So for those who are going to HUSA invited for this huddle, sila yung mga top 100 no trending ng ating Asia Pacific Growth 2022 sa Philippines. And also makikita ninyo lahat kayo, alam ko, are racing towards how to qualify towards the qualification towards the League of Champions. Makikita dito, ipapakita natin kung sino yung mga nag-qualify na and sino yung mga trending na magka-qualify pa for our League of Champions. This is very exciting training, no, or huddle, kasi we will all know kung ano yung status natin sa League of Champions and of course sa Asia Pacific Growth Incentive Trip in Athens. Very exciting, all right? Now, eto palagi naming fina-flash, no? Yung ating mga trainings for the month of August. Later on, after this training, I will also flash this one to let everyone know yung series ng mga trainings natin for the remaining days of August or remaining weeks of August. Ayan. So we have right now, no, our training for this evening, Leadership 101. So dinefine ko na kanina, wala akong nakitang nag-define ng leadership nila dito sa chat group, sa ating chat. Pero okay lang, no? We will all hear, no? We will all hear what Leadership 101 is. How to become an effective leader of USANA if you still have a lot of skills to learn, no? To become an effective leader of USANA, then this is the right training for all of you. Kapag nag-uumpisa ka pa lang, if you're still starting, no, your USANA business, definitely hindi ka pa talaga leader. We are not born to be a leader. Ang pagiging leader is being learned, no? Kailangan na natututunan ito along the way. Kapag sa mga everyday activities natin. And the perfect and the person that we've invited here exemplifies the real definition of being a leader, no? He is really a leader of his organization, a leader sa kanyang family, no? Our executive 5-star diamond director, Million Dollar Club member, and of course, recently, they just qualified sa ating Executive Diamond Summit in Peru. Guys, let us all welcome our executive 5-star diamond director, Ranel Blanco. Good evening, Ranel.
Yan. Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Gusto ko lang klaruhin, no? Medyo pause yung boses natin, no? Kasi galing tayo sa hatawan, no? Walang pahinga, no? So anyways, to all the leaders, no, I call you leaders, the almost 600 leaders in the room, no, congratulations for attending tonight, no, and of course, no, marami tayong mga siguro bago dito, no.
So, sa inyo,
so
parang,
sino dito sa inyo para
ngayon lang. Yun lang naka-attend ng Zoom meeting. Can you type 1?
Sir, dalawa po yung naka-on na ano nyo, na audio.
Teka lang, ma'am, ha? Hello po.
Ayan.
Nag-e-echo pa, sir.
Hello, yes, ma'am.
Yes, yan na po. Okay na po.
Ayan. So, okay guys, no? So, anyways, marami dito, no? Mayroon ding mga bago. And anyways, sa lahat ng mga leaders dito and nagsusumikap na maging leader din sa kanilang organization, welcome to our webinar this evening, no? And sa lahat ng mga leaders din na in-invite yung lahat ng mga distributor nila para mag-attend dito. Maraming salamat and thank you for this opportunity to serve, no, especially for the USANA Philippines. And of course, sa lahat ng mga uplines dyan, mga mentors, so good evening sa inyong lahat. And I hope I could add value to your team. And of course, I could add value also to the rest of the leaders na gustong maging makilala ng USANA Philippines, na makuha yung mga gusto nila sa buhay, yung mga pangarap nila na pinanggigilan nila, no. So and tonight, no, as I review the topic given by Ma'am Joyce, no, and of course the USANA, and as I look at it, leadership 101, no, I just try to figure out how can I share leadership in just a matter of an hour. And for me, it's very difficult to really craft leadership in an hour. But what I realize is that I will share to you guys what are my best practices na ginawa ko sa pagbibusiness ko sa USANA in the last 8 years, na yung common talaga na pabalik-balik na palagi talagang ina-apply in my organization. Because a lot of people, marami sa atin nag-aspire na gusto akong maging katulad niya na maging leader. But basically, if you model someone and you follow the footsteps of that person, whether it is offline or online, nakukopya mo talaga yan siya, no? So kaya nga, the good news is that leadership can be learned. And basically, lahat ng mga tao naman talaga may chance na maging leader, no? So ang importante lang sa atin is that umpisahan mo and you step up to be a leader in your organization, no? So I hope everybody is ready. And I hope everybody is right now doing good, no? Especially we are now on an MECQ mode, no? So alam naman natin, no, hindi ganun kadali yung buhay natin ngayon, no? And we are all in adjustment mode. But sabi nga nila, this is now the new normal. And of course, no, we are all leaders. So that is the number one quality of being a leader, is to adapt change and to really embrace the new change right now that we are now in the online world, no. So now moving on to my topic this evening, no. So since marami dito bago, no, allow me to of course share also my own journey in USANA, so that malalaman din ninyo saan din ako nanggaling, right? All right, no. So paki-type naman diyan, babe, para alam ko din sino dito yung mga, of course, no, yung mga coming from Visayas, no? From Visayas. So please type 1 if you are coming from Visayas. Yeah, no. So marami na mga taga Visayas, mga kauban ako na Bisaya, no. And of course, no, sino naman dito coming from Mindanao, Bisaya din, pero coming from Mindanao, type 2. Ayan, no? So medyo lumaki-laki na rin yung organization natin sa Mindanao. And of course, lahat ng mga Tagaluzon, type number 3, no? Iwagayway ang bandila ng mga Tagaluzon, no? Ayan, no? So marami sa Luzon, no? So anyways, I will be sharing to you this evening, no, how to create and develop leaders, and of course, how to make new associates stay or how to make new leaders stay in your organization? Because this is very crucial and this is very vital in our business, because in our business, I hope agree kayo lahat dito, no? In our business,
recording in progress.
This is a business of marami sa atin, alam natin to, no, na ang business natin sa iyo sana, this is a business of leadership, no? So, agree ba kayo sa akin na this is a business of leadership? No? Agree ba kayo? So, this is a business of leadership, and majority of the leaders, pag hindi natin na-build ang organization, they get discouraged because sabi nga nila, para hindi sa kanila yung pagbi-business na to. But if you are learning the very basic principles of leadership in doing in this business, huwag kang mag-alala because kaya mong i-build ang isana. Hindi siya ganun kakomplikado, hindi siya ganun kahirap, no? So, now, when I joined USANA, hindi kami naging mentor journalist, naging 5-star agad. Alam naman natin, hindi din kami naging leader ng USANA, no? Naging leader agad ng USANA. So, we started in a very beginning journey in our, sa pag-USANA namin. So, kung titingnan mo yung background na yan, no? So, kung titingnan mo yan, no? So, from 2013, no? Inarangkada namin, hinarurot namin yung USANA na halagang umabot kami in 2000, in 2020 we become 4-star and in 2021, no? So lockdown yung 2020, but we were able to make it, we were able to rank advance, and in 2021 we were able to become 5-star diamond director, no? So walang bago niyan kasi parang para sa akin parang normal na yung pag-run ko sa USANA, no? Parang it created a pattern na palagi kong dinuduplicate, palagi kong ginagawa. Ano yung ginagawa ko 2019, when we become 3-star and we become EDS. Yung ginagawa ko in 2021, in 2020, and then we become 4-star and then EDS pa rin. And then ginagawa namin in 2021, EDS pa rin. So ibig sabihin, nakopya natin yung mga pattern, paano talaga mag-rank advance, no? So, but more importantly, sa sinasabi ko is that I never stop working hard, no? Because that is one quality that a leader must possess, no? Dapat talaga, ganyan talaga tayo leaders, because how can you become a leader pag hindi ka nag-move, right? So, napaka-importante sa atin na mag-decide na mag-move. But who is really Ranel Blanco before USANA, no? So, I own a company, no? This is my company before USANA, and if you try to look at that company, I solely own the company. It's located in Pagadian City. So basically, doon din ako nag-umpisa sa pagbi-business ko sa pharmaceutical and then sa USANA business in 2013. And ito yung buhay ko before USANA. No, marami naman nakarinig sa akin, but for those new in the business, no, so where can you find, no? Bira ka makakita ng may-ari ng pharmaceutical na pumasok sa USANA. Kasi kung titingnan mo yung business namin, kabaliktaran to. Kabaliktaran to because kami, ang mindset namin, we don't like na gusto namin. You know, sorry for those in the pharmaceutical industry, but we're distributing product for cure, no? So, medyo, ang mindset namin is, ano, no, we are in cure. So, ito sa USANA is maintaining health. So, napakabaliktad, no? So, kung mayroon man sa atin dito na medyo hindi talaga swak, is ako yon, no? And during the time, no, when USANA was introduced to me by, of course, no, my brother, no, in 2013, no, this is my life, no? And if you try to look at that picture, no, so kung may man nagplano mag-pharmaceutical dyan, wag na lang, no? Kung titingnan mo yung picture na yan, no, hindi ganun ka guwapo, hindi ganun ka grabe yung stress din dati, no, in 2013. But buti na lang, I found USANA to the effort of my brother who really shared me this amazing opportunity, no? So, ibig sabihin is that wherever you are right now, whatever you do right now in life, you can start your side of business, no? Even though busy ka, because if you try to look at my situation in 2013, who knows, no? Na yung taong yun, pwede palang mag-USANA, no? And to cut the long story short, no? I made that declaration, no? That declaration in 2013. That one day, the small town of Pagadian, that USANA Pagadian will be the lightning rod in the entire country. I have that vision in my heart that sabi ko, itong USANA, makilala tong USANA sa Pagadian, that we can carry the plug. So meaning to say, wherever you are right now in doing in this business, wherever you are right now, ano yung sitwasyon mo ngayon, it doesn't matter. What matters is that you have to decide to do this business, carry the plug. Kaya nga natuwa ako sa video niyo sana na ginawa sa akin. Go where others do not. Go where others do not and never look back. I set the pace in 2013. Sabi ko, itong Ranel Blanco na to, na grabe yung stress sa pharmaceutical company niya. Ito yung mag-carry ng plug ng Philippines. And everyone in the room, the 600 or 700 leaders, 741 leaders in the chat in our webinar this evening, can be a plug carrier in you sana. It doesn't matter. We still have 20 weeks to go, guys. Grabe, guys. And I cannot imagine myself in the next 20 weeks what will happen in my organization since I keep moving today. I set the pace. I keep leading. And sabi ko sa mga leaders ko, we will go in Athens, but of course, we'll be part of the Growth 25 in the whole of Asia Pacific. Right? So, that was my story. And I hope you are inspired by my story because I did not start USANA from a big city. I started USANA in a very small town. But what happened today, we become the more dollar achievement in USANA. And walang madali dito sa USANA. Walang madali dito sa USANA. But being the owner of my own pharmaceutical before, sabi ko, I cannot imagine myself if I did not say yes to this opportunity. I did not make it serious the first time when I do in this business in 2013. Sabi ko sa asawa ko ngayon, sabi ko, buti na lang tinrabaho ko. Buti na lang sineryoso ko in 2013. So when pandemic came, no, in 2020, hindi talaga kami masyadong na-worry because sabi ko, build na yung mga leaders natin, build na yung organization natin, we'll do it, we'll continue to set the standard and set the pace and continue to move on. So if you try to look at that background and being like the one of the pillars in the USANA Philippines today and where I'm coming from, parang titingnan mo, Mentor Ranel, are you born as a leader or leader are made or leader are born? Can you answer me this question for me, guys? No, para at least we have an interaction this evening. Are leaders are born or made? Can you type in the chat box? Depende sa answer mo. Walang problema, walang mali sa atin. Tama lahat ng answer, depende sa perspective mo. So, ayan, no? Ang dami, no? So, made. Ang leader daw is, ayan, born, no? Mayroon ding born, mayroong made, no? So, depende sa perspective natin. But basically, tama yung sabi ni Ma'am Michelle kanina, no? In the book of John Maxwell, no? Ang leader talaga, hindi talaga siya born. Kung hindi, the leaders are really made, no? Made talaga yung leaders. Kasi wala namang pinanganak dito na alam yung pangalan niya, right? The only equality sa atin lahat is that yung pinanganak tayo dito is that wala namang pinanganak dito na sabi ko sa magulang ko, Ranel Blanco yung pangalan ko, we are empty, right? And wala namang pinanganak dito sa mundong to na mayroon ng alam sa leadership, right? And wala namang pinanganak dito sa atin na may damit, tama ba? So we're equal being when we are born in this earth. But why are some become leaders and some become followers, right? And in the law of proximity, ganyan talaga yan, no? So who you surround with? You are the average of the five people that surrounds you. Meaning to say, if you are surrounded with followers, then you become followers. If you are surrounded with leaders, then you become leaders. Kaya proximity, sabi palagi ni Tony Robbins, is power. Kailangan talaga, you surround yourself with leaders who are fired up, who are visionary to be the lightning rod in every organization, kung saan man silang organization, right? Because kung titingnan mo yung background ko, titingnan mo, sino magakala, yung taong yon, yun yung top one in the whole Philippines right now sa USANA. So imaginein mo yung background niyan. And basically, in our own family, we are a leaders, right? And kung titingnan mo yung picture na yan, sino magakala, yung taong yun makakita ng USANA, makahanap ng USANA, hindi naman talaga mayaman yung background namin, right? Kung titingnan mo yan. And nung pinanganak tayo dito, parehas-parehas tayo lahat. But depende sa ano yan. For me, it really matters. Proximity really matters in this business. Who is your surrounding? Sino yung palagi mong kasama? Because when I enter into the pharmaceutical industry, I become also a great leader because tinrabaho ng tinrabaho ng tinrabaho ko. By the way, guys, number one rule in leadership, walang leader na walang performance. You cannot be promoted or you cannot be called as a leader when you just command your people and you are not performing. Meaning to say, in our business in USANA, leader must sponsor first before the downlines, right? Leader must sponsor first before the new associates. Ganyan talaga dito sa pag-business natin. Leaders must show up first, no? So if you look at that award, no, I'm not bragging anyone to in the room, but I just flash back, no, where I become a leader, no, where I started to become a leader, and in our own little way, we are a leader, right? And it relates with how USANA, especially when we received this award in 2021. In 2021, USANA. Hindi naman siguro tayo bigyan ng USANA kung hindi tayo qualify ng Dr. Dennis Waitley Leadership Award, no, as the first in the Philippines. Ang ibig ko lang sabihin sa inyo, guys, ano yung principle na ituturo natin dito? Ano yung ituturo natin dito direct with the tips na ano yung pwedeng gawin? Pwede mong i-apply to and pwede mong i-apply sa organization mo and basically sasabog yung buong organization mo in 2021, even though if there are meaning weeks like 20 weeks or 19 weeks more, right? So, kayang-kaya yan. Ang ibig kong sabihin, kayang-kaya yan. Bakit? Sabi dito ni John Maxwell, no matter who you are, you can lead and lead well. So, sabi ni John Maxwell yan, no matter where you are, even though saan ka ngayon, in your business, whether you are a sharer, you are a believer, builder, achiever, or directors ka man na bago, you have to really step up to become a leader. Question, how will I step up to become a leader? The only way to step up to become a leader, start leading yourself right now. You get to read books, improve yourself, and of course, along the way, when you go out, people will look at you as you are a leader because you show up, right? You show up. Don't complicate things. Don't, because many people like, I really want to be a leader, but I don't know if I am qualified to be the one, no, right? So you have to really start leading your team. So indirect, sila yung mga tao. Ito yung mga tao naging leader. Sila yung mga tao na bago pa lang sa organization. Sila yung palaging gustong maging bida. No, don't get me wrong, but gustong maging bida. Para bang they want to be involved that gusto nila palagi silang kasali. So meaning to say, walang leader na they just wait and see for things to happen. For example, in our organization, in USANA, marami sa atin dito sa USANA that pinabayaan lang minsan natin yung nag-organize ng event, right? Minsan, we just wait for the Zoom link to send to us, but the one who prepare everything, the one who are involved, especially when you have live event before pandemic, they are the one who become a leader today in the USANA, right? But the one who are keep on waiting for things to happen, giving comment, dapat ganito, ganito, they become a follower until today, right? So the good news in leadership, because you can learn leadership, no? And here we go, developing leaders. And Ma'am Michelle defined leadership, no? Now, in the definition, no, in the book, in the definition of leadership, leader is a person who influences a group of people towards the achievement of the goal. Guys, take note, achievement of the goals. So any one of you here in the room, including myself, if I have no goal this week, if I have no goal for my organization in the next week, in the next month, or for in the year, meaning to say, hindi ako leader. So napaka-importante pala, why is leadership associated into the performance of an individual? Because ganyan talaga when you become a leader. Kanina nga narinig ko yung video ng USANA, yung piniplay kanina. The global leader in nutrition. Iko, how come? The global, I'm working in a global leader in nutrition like USANA. And then me, myself, as an associate, I am not a leader. I am not doing my job, no, right? So, kaya nga sabi ko kanina, grabe talaga, no? USANA is a global leader in nutrition. Pwede pala, yung leader pala, hindi lang tao. Pwede rin maging company, right? So, ganyan talaga yung business. So, mentoran yan. If you're talking about leadership today, the basic about leadership, so how to build a solid business in USANA, especially duplicating leaders down the line? Take it from me, guys. I learn from my own mistakes. I will not be sharing to you this evening na yung bagay na hindi ko pinag-practice. Because what for? Reading books and then getting that principles and then isi-share. Kung ano pinapractice yan. So walang kwenta din, right? So but I'll be sharing to you in my own experience when I lost all my downlines, when I achieved gold director. No, after achieving gold director rank, alam ba ninyo na after becoming gold director, lahat ng mga leaders ko, lahat ng mga downlines ko, halos nawala sila lahat and tatlo na lang yung natira. And imagine mo during that time, it was the defining moment that I learned that there is a really a big difference between being a boss and being a leader. Because I applied the strategy or the principles of being a boss when I own a company. I think that USANA can be do that way. I always say, you go. In USANA, you cannot say that you go. Of course, you always say in USANA that let's go, right? So ganyan talaga ang pagbi-business natin sa USANA. You say always that you go, meaning to say boss. When you say that, let's go, a leader, right? So basically today, until today, if you try to ask me today, Mentor Ranel, what is your experience, the hardest experience that you get in doing in this business? Now, the hardest experience in doing in this business is ito yon. Napakahirap dati, no? Imagine mo dati, nung nagbi-business ako sa USANA, I experienced the struggles. If you try to look at the picture, anong picture yan? Anong picture yan? So look at that picture, guys. That picture simply defines us or simply illustrate. Ito yung picture na yan. Ang tawag niyan, leadership crisis. Sino dito sa inyo, can you type on the chat box, sino dito sa inyo na naka-experience na mawala ang mga leaders niyo? Sino dito sa inyo? Sige nga, type in the chat box yung para bang mentor kami. Nawala talaga. Grabe talaga. Hindi kami. Ayan. Good news, this night, this training is for you. Bakit? Ito yon. In my business in USANA, I also experienced the same and I have sympathy to you guys. Because parehas tayo nang na-experience, right? Kung titingnan mo yung ano niyan, kung titingnan mo yung picture na yan, grabe talaga yung ano, grabe. Talaga yung na-experience ko kasi leadership crisis. Balikan ninyo, do you have a leader or mayroon ka bang downline dati na sabi mo, sayang mentor, kung ano lang sana, nakip ko yun, siguro gold na ako. Or ano na ako ngayon mentor Anel, diamond ako ngayon mentor Anel kasi lima sila nawala. Right? So marami sa atin na ganyan yung experience. But don't worry guys because in the end, wala namang perfecto nag-umpisa dito sa USANA, right? Naging leader, tapos bigla siyang talaga pagpasok, leader na agad. Kaya nga palagi kong sinasabi, nung pumasok sa USANA ang isang individual, and then sabihin niya, USANA madali yan, wala akong ano dyan sa USANA. Yung USANA, gawin ko yan, tapos kayang-kaya kong gawin yan, right? So, natawa ako kasi sabi ko, ako naman ganyan ako dati. Grabe yung ano ko dati kasi sabi ko, may-ari akong kandang company, CEO ako, kayang-kaya ko to lahat. Pero in the end, there was only 3 downlines left. Kaya nga, itong topic na to, napaka-importante sa atin because this will really help your business, grow your business, yung business natin, lalaki yung organization natin. Ayan. So now, moving on po, ayusin ko lang, no? So number one is that kung nakita ninyo tong ano, kung nakita niyo yung picture na yan, no, sa I hope klaro, no. So kung nakita niyo yung picture na yan, number one is that in developing leaders, number one is that you have to know their deep why, your lead by example, you train your associates, you personalize your approach, you lead them according to their highest values. So yung mga yon, actually pinapractice na natin yan. Basically, kung nakita mo yan, ginagawa mo yan everyday, right? Ginagawa mo yan everyday. And in becoming a leader in USANA, kung titingnan mo tong picture na to, no? Kung titingnan mo yung slide na yan. Bakit ba, Mentor Ranel, binabalik na naman yung deep why? Palagi nating narinig yan. Sabi nila, if you know your why, the easier the how, right? But kung titingnan mo yung deep why niyan, bakit mayroon siyang nakalagayng urgent? Bakit? Kasi kung yung urgent why na yan, kung totoo na yung urgent why, is pag yung urgent why mo daw, marami na sanang naging diamond. Marami sa atin mayroon tayong why. And in fact, bakit kailangan siyang balikan in developing leaders? Pag na-discourage ang distributor natin, to remind them, bakit sila nag-join sa USANA? And ano yung pinaka-or na gusto nilang gawin? Bakit sila nag-join sa USANA? Minsan, nag-join sila sa USANA because of what? You have to talk to them sincerely about their deep why, the purpose, the belief system that inspire them. Kasi ako, kung balikan ko yung time, bakit ako nag-join sa USANA? The motivation is not the extrinsic one. Because there are two types of motivation. The number one is the intrinsic and the extrinsic. And then the second one is the intrinsic. Meaning to say, yung dati pag-join ko sa USANA, ang gusto ko is mapatravel ko yung wife ko. So hindi ako pwedeng magninega-nega. Hindi ako pwedeng mag-give up. Kasi nire-remind ni Upline, ni mentor ko, na sabi niya, di ba gusto mong mag-travel ang pamilya mo? So ito na yon. Di ba gusto mo makabili ng kotse, ng bahay? Kaya trabahuin mo yung pagbi-business mo. Yes, gusto ko. Kaya nga, you have to remind your leaders, guys. The extrinsic motivation, ano yung why nila? Bakit sila nag-join? Marami sa atin nag-join sa USANA because of mayroong pera. So yung motivation is the intrinsic. What is extrinsic? Nag-join sila ng USANA because they want to be involved. They want to be in a group na positive ang mga mindset. They want to be involved like this. They want to be involved in giving. They want to be involved. They want growth, no? Kami ni Mentor Jonalyn, when we first experienced the trip in Cambodia, which USANA invited to us to be in Cambodia, in the feeding program in Cambodia, sabi ko, I will never stop. I will never stop working so hard in this company because ito yung intrinsic motivation ko. Ang intrinsic motivation ko na kailangan nandito ako sa company, that all I have to do is to work hard and makuha na yung purpose ko. Your passion, no? So kailangan alam natin yan. Napaka-importante yan. So unang-una, the why should be what? It should be urgent. I-remind natin ang mga leaders natin, yung muntik nang nawala na mga leaders natin. Balikan natin, tomorrow, kausapin natin. Di ba nag-join kasi sana kasi yung mother mo, ipa-travel mo? Di ba nag-join kasi sana, di ba yung anak mo, gusto mo, kasama mo siya palagi? Para hindi na siya ma-discourage, right? Para hindi na siya ma-discourage. Di ba nag-join ka sa USANA, ma'am, because you want growth? So you have to remind. Huwag natin gawin yung parang, ay, pag ayaw mo, ayaw ko rin. Guys, maraming tao masayang pag ganyan yung attitude natin. Kaya kailangan mag-grow tayo sa aspect na yan. So, mentor, sabi nga, you can carry you can help a thousand, but you cannot carry trip not the bag, hindi at your back. Hindi mo naman i-carry yan. Kailangan mo lang siyang iparemind na bakit siya nag-join sa USANA. And basically, kahit ako, balikan ko the time na bakit ako nag-sign up, mayroon akong personal motivation na nagpa-join sa akin. And lahat ng tao nag-join yan dahil sa na-trigger natin yung need or na-trigger natin yung nagpa-motivate o nagpa-encourage sa kanila. Basically, no? So, ayun, no? So, now, moving on. So, number two is lead by example. Now, you know their why. You lead them, right? So, isulat mo, i-lead mo sila. So, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. Let's go. Don't say that you go. Don't say that you hit your goal. We will hit our goals, right? You work hand in hand, working together as like as one family. That you are in the same boat, you are in the same bus, no? Marami sa atin, alam to, no? This is the very basic principle of leadership. Pag sinasabing lead by example. But this is the most violated principle in leadership. Marami sa atin na palagi lang, alam ko yung leadership niya, lead by example, pre, lead by example, pare. Pero marami sa atin, we are only doing the talk, but we are not walking the talk. We are not keep on talking and talk and talk, and but not walking our talk. You have to walk the talk as a leader in USANA. It is very important because remember, it's business. You're always on stage. You're always on stage. Everybody is watching you every day. When you walk, when you go out in your house, when you are an associate, when you are a distributor, when you are late with your client, when you're late with your associate for some goal setting whatsoever, what happened? They will mark you as, ito, nandito na naman itong palaging late, nagsisilpi na. Ayan, patay tayo dyan, right? You have to walk the talk at all times. Because remember this, guys, you're always on stage. Guys, in this business, you cannot just do in this business like, okay lang yan, kasi, yo, leader ko naman, ako naman yung leader dito. Okay lang yan, bahala na yan sila. Remember, guys, human as we are, pumasok tayo sa iyo sana, nag-differential lang tayo sa rank. Pero, matalino ang mga associate natin. Matalino ang mga distributor natin. They know if you are lying, right? So, napaka-importante sa atin yan as a leader. Because we are the pillars, we are the goal directors, or we are the directors enough, or we are the associates na pumasok dito and we're expecting to bring new clients. Kaya nga palaging sinasabi sa akin, mayroong nagtanong sa akin, sabi niya, Mentor, how will I magnet people? Yung mga top caliber, wow, magnet people, top caliber individual. Human as we are, according to John Maxwell, we're like waters, we find our own level. Meaning to say, kaya nga mayroon tinatawag na result close because you borrow the result of the other people, right? Human as we're like waters, we find our own level. Kaya nga napaka-importante, if you try to look at this slide, napaka-importante yung growth na side. That you grow as a person, you elevate yourself, and you influence the other people, right? Na medyo mataas din. You grow yourself, as you grow yourself, you influence na mas mataas na tao. You grow yourself. Kaya nga, result really tells. Now, ngayon, tanong ngayon, pag wala kang resulta, pag hindi ka mag-advance, how will you elevate your result? How will you increase your influence, right? How will you lead? By example, in your organization. Kaya mo, titingnan mo, why are people slowing down? I'm not slowing down my business because business sense. Bakit ko slow down yung business ko? Pag slow down ko yung business ko, the whole of my organization and the whole of my downlines will slow down. Basically, because this is the business of leadership, right? So, tamang-tama po. Tamang-tama po talaga. So, business ko sa leader ko. Bakit? Sabi ko, palagi ko lang sinasabi sa kanila, lead by example. Guys, I have to remind everyone in the room, even though if you're running a PPS, start leading today. You can be a great leader in Yosana. And don't worry if kailan mangyayari yon. Because hanggang habang buhay tayo dito sa Yosana. And sabi nga ni Ma'am Cherry, Yosana can outlive all of us. Meaning to say, because this is an NYSE listed company. Where can you find an NYSE listed company na nawala in 20 years? Right? Wala naman talaga. No, wala naman talagang nawala, no? Kaya nga I keep moving. And bakit ba talaga Mentor Ranel? So nakinuha mo yung goal niyan. Kasi it's a promise, no? It's a promise in the Bible that work hard and become a leader and be lazy and become a slave. Kaya alam ko pag nagtrabaho talaga ako, may resulta yan kasi it's a promise and never naman na fail yung promise niyan, right? So I always keep moving. I will always keep moving. And this is somehow the hardest run of all the run. But wala akong pakialam sa hardest run. Ang may pakialam ko, alam ko i-run ko yan, right? Yun lang ang may pakialam ako. So be specific on training according to their needs. Of course, napaka-importante yan. You have to show them how to do the business. Napaka-importante yung showing them, working them daily. You working them daily. Bakit, Mentor Ranel? Because where can you find a businessman na pag sinasabi, Mentor, bakit ka palagi nagtatrabaho everyday? Sabi ko, wala ka namang nakitang negosyante na hindi magtatrabaho everyday. Wala kang nakita na may-ari ng isang store na hindi open everyday. That is the mindset of a real entrepreneur in Yosana, a real leader in Yosana. Ganyan talaga ang mindset dapat. No? Empleyado, pwedeng mag-absent yan. Pero pag entrepreneur ka, hindi ka pwedeng mag-absent. Mentor, saan na yung freedom ngayon? You can have freedom you reach the top, right? Pag halimbawa, naging diamond ka na, pwede ka na sa Madrid. 2 weeks. Been 1 month in the US, right? But for now, since we're building the business, you have to keep moving. And huwag ka nang mag-ask ng parang, ah, ganito ba talaga? Saka na lang pag wala ng COVID, wala ng pandemic 2020, nandito Delta, nandito pa si Lambda. I'm not saying, guys, nalalabas tayo sa mga tao, but ang point ko sa inyo, you have to maneuver your organization. You have to sell. Ito yung goal, ito yung goal. Because ganito lang yan. Sabi palagi, last success is a science. It leads clue. If maraming mga leaders during the lockdown period, ibig sabihin, kaya mo rin gawin. So, lang natin, bro, we really have to reconnect ourselves. Reconnect our upline, reconnect to the corporate, reconnect everything, and do you work with the cross line. Bakit kailangan cross line, Mentoranel? Kailangan yan because sabi nga ni John Maxwell, one is too small for greatness. One is too small for greatness. Don't isolate yourself that you can do everything. Because the moment that you do that, alam ko, mabagsak din yung organization mo. And I've been in this business for 8 years already. Yung 8 years ko, wala kong sinayang na oras. Sabi ko nga, palagi yung ibang mga leaders, sabi nila, grabe talaga mentoran yun. Ganyan. When I always look at my watch every day, relo ko man or cellphone ko man, I always see to it that ginamit ko yung mga time ko every day. Because I don't want regret. Na baka sayangin pagdating ng panahon, sayang yung mga time ko, right? Sayang, no? Gusto kong walang regret. Number 3 is that you have to really train your associates. Ito. And basically, a lot of misleading, especially in USANA, sometimes misleading, like misleading in sharing the product, misleading in sharing the comp, misleading, especially in our ethics education, napaka-importante yan. Bakit na mislead? Because leaders na tinatamad i-train ang mga distributor. Kaya nga sabi ko palagi, don't give them the fish, but teach them how to catch the fish. Why? You help them to eat in a day. But if you teach them how to catch the fish, you help them to eat in a lifetime. Right? Kaya nga napaka-importante sa atin na as a leader today, you have to train our associates the right way in doing in this business. Because at the end of the day, ipamana mo to sa next generation mo. Baka yung ipamana natin sa next generation, mali na pag-USANA, right? You cannot become a top one income earner in USANA Philippines or you cannot become a diamond pag mali ang pag-USANA natin, right? Kaya nga you really have to train yourself as a champion. Halimbawa ngayon, Ma Michelle kanina, sabi niya, in-encourage niya, like, message your associates and distributor to attend into Zoom meeting, guys. Kahit isang linya lang, makuha nila dito. That will help them become a gold director, right? That will help them keep one leaders. Na yung why pala, i-remind niya, right? Na kaya pala tita, nag-sign up ka dahil sa magulang mo, right? Dapat ganyan talaga. And of course, in developing leaders, this is last and we'll move to the how to keep them, how to keep the new leaders. Develop your leaders according to their highest values, their personality, their traits, right? Maximize their strength and especially values. Example of values, for example, I have a new sign up, yung values niya talaga is grabe talaga yung values niya. Sabi niya, mentor, I have a values of saving money. So saving yung values niya, so hindi ko talaga kukutrahin yan. Saving yung values niya, right? Yung personality niya, napaka-choleric niya, napaka-melancholic, napaka-phlegmatic, napaka-ano, no? So halimbawa, napaka-choleric niya, so hindi ko talaga siya babanggain kasi mag-aaway kaming dalawa. No, it's not that I'm the 5-star diamond director. It's only by rank that I am a 5-star. But in dealing my new lead, limit niya strong din. So pag strong siya, kakalma ako. Pag hindi naman siya naging strong, ako naman yung maging strong, right? So ganyan talaga. And it's humility. It's humility when you are going to adjust. When you're going to adjust, hindi naman porque upline, ilang beses kahit ilang beses ako maging mentor dito sa USANA, mentor is just a name. But for me, if we don't care our people, wala pa rin pakialam. To us, kung ano yung sasabihin natin, unless din daw di to us. Kaya napaka-importante sa atin yan. Yung values nila, wag nating suwayin ang mga values ng mga leader natin. Halimbawa, mayroon akong leader na mayroon sila mga prayer meeting, ganyan. Hindi ko talaga susuwayin yan. Because we're not just pumasok tayo sa USANA, mayroon lang tayong kanya-kanyang ginagawa. And tayo as leader, don't mislead. Don't mislead na parang, susunod ka dito, susunod ka dito. Kasi ako yung mentor mo, ako yung coach mo. Diba? Gusto mo kasi, so, no, you cannot do that. Because mayroon tayong mga sarili-sarili ng ginagawa bago tayo nag-USANA, right? So, guys, take it from me. And I hope, no open stall. And I hope this will somehow enlighten to us. Because lahat naman sa atin, gustong maging leader, right? Gustong maging top. And alam naman natin, the most important quality of becoming a leader is what? Is humility. When you admit that you're wrong and then you change, right? Kasi wala pa rin makatutulong sa atin if you keep on self-proclaim tayo na tama tayo, right? So, napaka-importante yan. And I would like to leave you this one, guys, bago tayo mag-move into the next slide. If you are going to recruit people in your organization, napaka-importante ito. And most of the leaders, they're looking for example. Ano yung gusto ninyong na leader sa organization? Na may character sila na ganito, may trait sila na ganito. Anong gusto niyo? Yung may integrity, sige. Honest, focus, sige. Paki-type on the chat box. Yung perspective niyo na gusto ninyo. Yung gusto niyo, yung grabe, yung passionate talaga mentor, yung grabe talaga clarity. Ayan, resilient. Sino pa? Committed, grounded, ayun, passionate, honest, determination, care, focus. So these are the attributes. These are the attributes that you need to have a leader in your organization na ganito. It's like that when you have a company or you are the GM or you are the 5-star in your organization. You are now the CEO, right? You are the president in your own company. And you want to recruit people like marami yung traits na gito, yung nasa screen. You can screenshot that one. Gusto natin, ganyan talaga yung mga traits, mentoranel. Gusto ko talaga yan. Pag ganyan ang mga tao ko sa organization, ewan ko na lang what will happen in my organization. Sasabog talaga. But, oh yan, unstoppable, empowering, supportive. Marami yan. And we want that people to be in our organization. But the simplest way to attract them to be in our organization is, my question is, do you possess that attributes? Possess that integrity, that honesty, that focus, that passion, that respect, that excellence, that confidence, that clarity, care, compassion, humility, empowering, genuine, supportive, and collaborative. If you did not possess that attribute, then don't wish. Don't wish. First thing first, possess that attributes. Have that kind of traits and attract them. That is how to become a great leader in USANA, right? So I hope this somehow give you enlightenment, man, because marami sa atin gusto makahanap ng magaling na leader, right? Marami sa atin. Now, moving on in our topic this evening, no? So kaya nga kami mentor journaling talking of values. One of my highest values as a leader in USANA is giving. And alam ni Junaline yan. Alam ng asawa ko yan. One of my highest values is giving. So when we experience, no, Junaline also has the values of giving. But depende kasi yan, ano yung top priority mo na values. My values is giving. So when we experience trip in Cambodia, sabi ko, this is it. And this is the company that dito na ko tatanda. Kasi sabi ko, this is really my heart. And until today, a lot of people are asking questions. You are the elite bonus recipient. You are the top one. You are the highest paid associates in the whole of USANA. No? Napakagandang tingnan. But why you are not stopping? What's stopping you? Because you are a leader in USANA? Yes, I am a leader in USANA. But one thing for sure, bakit hindi ako nag-stop? Because I'm still very, very far from where I wanna be or where I wanna go in my life. In one of my values in USANA is giving. And also my values to my community, because I have a dream. A school for the poorest of the poor and a hospital for the poorest of the poor. And I will not stop, guys. Maybe you laugh at me tonight because of that goal, but one day we'll see each other. And sasabihin ko sa inyo, I'm here because gawin ko talaga yan. And I don't care how long it will take. Basta gawin ko talaga yan. And wala akong ibang gagawin. Sorry, income ng USANA ang igawa ko dyan. So that is why I keep moving. And why I keep moving to be the top one in the whole world. What for? What is money after all, right? Money is just an emotion, right? So for me, the thing that you do for money is the most important thing. And that is why we keep moving and we keep soaring high. It's not for the investment. It's not for the beautiful house, beautiful cars. Of course, you can get it along the way if you work hard. But first thing first, where did you put it? Because sabi ni Tony Robbins, if you are growing, you are alive. You are happy. But if you are giving, you are 10 times more happy if you are giving. Kaya nga, today maybe your need is not to contribute, is not to grow, but security maybe in Maslow's hierarchy of need. Maybe nandito pa kayo sa baba ngayon, pero in the end, matutunan mo din that in you sana, you can just open your heart to give, right? So ganyan malalim itong pag-iusana natin. Kaya nga mga leaders dyan, pukawin ninyo yung mga kaluluwa natin. Kailangan magtrabaho na magtrabaho tayo kasi marami pa tayong tulungan, right? So kailangan natin yan. My wife, Jonaline, ano yung values niya? Isa sa highest values niya. Ang values ng asawa ko, travel. Isa sa ano niya, parang fun. Pag gusto niya, maparelax, right? So kinuha ko lahat ng travel. Sabi niya, kunin natin yan lahat, daddy, kasi gusto ko yan. Kaya nga, leading them according to their highest values, their personalities, and of course their traits is napaka-importante when you know your leaders. Kaya nga, instead of talking more to your associates, ito yung mabilin ko sa inyong lahat. Instead of talking to them, listen to them. Talk to them. Ano yung gusto nilang to listen than to talk, right? So ganyan talaga. No, ito mga travel ng USANA upcoming. Sabi ko tina-target ko na yan. Sabi ko grabe tong next travel ng USANA. Mayroon na namang mga Monaco, no? So hindi ko alam saan yan. Actually, hindi ko alam saan yung mga Peru, pero kinuha natin. Hindi ko alam saan yung Monaco, pero alam ko kukunin natin yan, right? Now, I'll give you the last 4 tips maybe in the next 10 to 15 minutes. How to make your new leader stay. And this is somehow na palagi ko talagang ginagawa and I really apply it every day. Ito po, no? Ito po. So number one is that you have to make it sure that you are in the same mission or you're in the same boat, you're in the same bus, you're in the same mission, the same passion, right? Nothing is more important than showing and modeling them how to do the business. But of course, guys, napaka-importante din na alamin ninyo para hindi sila mawala. Baka iba na yung ginagawa ng mga leaders natin, right? Iba na yung ginagawa ng mga leaders natin. Kaya napaka-importante, you have to make it sure that you are in the same mission and malalaman mo lang to kung palagi mo silang kinakausap. Pag hindi mo sila palaging kinakausap and you're just only concerned with the points, what will happen? What will happen? Unti-unti yang mag-overload hanggang sa one day, excuse me po, wala na yung distributor mo. Communication is the key. Sabi nga, marami sa atin na palagi nating pinupush, right? Pero did you communicate them? Napaka-importante yung communication na yan. So the passion to share USANA's vision, Dr. Myron Wen's vision. Do you have the same heart to really do this business? By all integrity. Trabaho ba talaga nila para gawin mo yung business na yan? You have to correct everything. As a leader, we are not a perfect leader, by the way. But you can eliminate You can eliminate if you communicate. Eliminate problems in your organization. Kaya knowing you are in the same boat or the same bus is very important. Number two, very important in our business, solidify relationship. Ito, maraming ano dito. Maraming failure dito kasi sabi nila, we all need a healthy relationship between the corporate, between the USANA distributor, and of course, between cross lines and between downlines, right? Marami sa atin. And if you really want to lead your organization, napaka-importante talaga to. You have to really know how to solidify your, ano. Marami sa atin, mag-meeting lang. Mag-meeting kasi may goal. Nag-meeting kasi may goal. But do you really build relationship? Because the foundation of relationship, listen to me this one. The foundation of relationship is what? I mean leadership. The foundation of leadership is relationship. If this is leadership, then the foundation is relationship. And the foundation of relationship is what? Trust. And the foundation of trust is trustworthiness. Kaya nga napaka-importante yung relationship na yan to really keep your leaders and your downlines para mas ma-minimize na to yung attrition. Now, there's an argument. Saan yung i-choose? Ranel, mayroon kaming relationship, wala naman siyang performance. Or mayroon siyang performance, wala naman kaming magandang relationship. Actually, you cannot choose between relationship and performance. Because you have to select both. Bakit kailangan yung dalawa talaga, Mentor Ranel? Because hindi rin pwede, marami kang maganda yung relationship, wala namang performance, right? Hindi rin pwede, may performance, walang relationship. Leading your organization is always like that. And when you have the best relationship with your downlines, your uplines, your crosslines, and to the corporate team, and to your community as well, guys, magaan ang buhay. Ang tawag niya dyan, hayahay ang buhay, right? So team bonding, team building, napaka-importante yan. But don't get me wrong, mayroon talagang mga misunderstanding. All you have to do is to keep moving, and keep moving, and keep moving, right? So ano yung una is knowing that you are in the same boat. The second is what? Solidifying relationship. The third is develop your associates. Why? Why I need to develop and grow my associates? Napaka-importante yan because when people are growing, they will not live in your organization. When I have growth, of course, I will not leave you sana. I will not leave my team. I will not leave my upline, my cross lines. Bakit? Nag-grow ako. And as a leader, this is the highest calling of our leadership. Na kailangan tayo makita natin ang mga leaders natin na mag-grow. So paano mag-grow kung hindi mag-rang advance? Mentor, pwede bang mag-grow, magbasa ng libro? Yes, pwede ka rin mag-grow, magbasa ka ng libro. Pero nothing is more effective than changing your colors. Nothing is more effective than running in the next 13 weeks. Nothing is more effective than running to executive gold, running to LS, running to gold directorship, ruby, emerald, diamond, or kahit anong rank niyan. Guys, pressure is a privilege. Pressure is always a privilege. This is our privilege to grow. You know Michael Jordan? One of the traits of Michael Jordan is excellence. When your leaders are pushing you, allow them to push, guys, and allow them to work with you. And when someone is giving you goals, get it. Why? Like Michael Jordan, when he passed the ball to his colleagues or sa kanyang teammates, if hindi niya i-dribble yan, hindi i-dribble ng teammates niya yan, hindi na siya magpapasa ng bola. Bakit ganyan ang traits niya? Because he's testing that guy if mag-respond ba. Now, in our leadership in USANA, growing our associates is all about changing colors, reading books, attending seminars, or whatsoever. But more importantly is the performance. More importantly is seeing your leaders na recognize this afternoon as bronze, as silver, as new gold, as ruby. Guys, that is growth. And walang nawala sa iyo sana. Ako, tingnan niyo. My background is a CEO of my own company. My wife is a teacher. Pag hindi kami nag-grow ni Mentor Junaline, pag hindi ako naging goal director naging ruby, baka bumalik na ako sa pharmaceutical ko. Binigyan ko kayo ng tips. If you recruit high caliber individual, kailangan lang sila may rank. Bakit? Mahirap kaya mag-quit. Gold ka na, ruby ka na, emerald ka na, diamond ka na. Bakit? Magbago yung identity ng tao. May identity as a CEO, as a boss. Hindi pwede na wala akong rank sa iyo sana, right? Kaya kailangan, so matalino talaga yung brother ko. Pinarang advance ako niya ng gold director, nag-LS ako para maaga kong nakita ang, nakita ko yung Yusana, ah, grabe pala tong Yusana, cruise ship pala to, no? So ganyan, maaga kong nakita. Kasi pag hindi niya nagawa yon and my identity, hindi ko mag-attend ng training. Kasi I'm a boss, I'm a CEO, what for, right? So parang ganyan yung mindset, no? So, importante yung growth. And maraming, hindi na, maraming nawala na distributor dahil dito. Kasi hindi sila nag-grow. Ah, ilang weeks na tayo dito sa Yusana, ilang months na tayo dito. Nasasayang yung time natin dito, ganyan, ganyan. Pero if they are making result, believe me guys, magstay sila sa Yusana. Basta, do it right. Importante, you do it right. Alam natin yung right at hindi. Huwag na nating explain yan, right? So dapat ganyan talaga. So kami ni Mentor Jonalyn, growth is one of our the priority, no? Ito talaga yung priority namin, the growth of the growth naming dalawa, growth ng mga tao, ganyan. And parehas tayo. Kailangan lang natin mag-step up and kailangan lang nating mag-lead, no? So ganyan talaga yan, no? So in the end, it's all about what? It's all about action. Gusto mo talagang mag-grow? Gusto mong ma-master ang business niyo sana? You have to take massive action every single day. Maraming alam na natin kailangan massive action, pero marami ang hindi alam na kailangan umpisahan ang massive action. Kailangan, kaya nga sabi ni Hilin Song, change is easy but making decision is the most difficult thing. You take massive action in your business, guys, again, imposibleng hindi ka mag-rank advance if you take massive action. Yung science ng success ng Yusana, tinuturo ng lahat ng mga mentors na diamonds natin. Kaya imposibleng hindi mangyayari yan. Right? No? So, change your rank before 2021. Like these three courageous diamond directors in Cagayan, no? Mayroon pang sumunod sa Cagayan, no? Of course, no? Tatlo, no? Kay Joel Chua, of course, Eddie, and of course, Rolly, and of course, dito sa Cebu. Nandito ngayon si Mentor Tony and Chipo, running for EDS. And of course, sumunod dito yung under kay Mentor Eric Cheng na si Ma'am Mary T, no? So, under ni Sir Ding na nagro-run din ng Diamond. So, meaning to say, there's no stopping us, even though lockdown, even though pandemic. Guys, it takes only one decision away from where you are today to where you wanna be in your life. Before the end of the year, change your rank, no? And mentors, meaning to say, pag December na, no? The best way to do it is now. Because today you are excited. Today you are bombarded with learnings. This is the right time to really change our color. Hashtag tayo pagkatapos itong training na to. Hashtag tayo lahat. Change color tayo lahat. Para at least ki-create ng noise in the entire Yusana Philippines. Ano bang nangyayari dito? Change color. From yellow to ruby. From ruby to green, of course, from green to blue, hashtag change color tayo, guys. Believe me, guys. Alam ni Lord ang ginagawa natin. So, imposibleng hindi tayo i-bless. So, kaya nga, trabahuin ang trabahuin natin to. Of course, the last but not the least is constantly increase momentum. Majority sa mga leaders na nawala because they are not growing, that's number one. And walang relationship, they're not growing, they're not in the same bus. But more importantly, momentum will solve 80% of our problems, according to John Maxwell. Momentum will solve whatever problem that you have right now. Momentum will solve 80% of your problem. Growing the business is all about creating a momentum. And the good news of creating a momentum, ang momentum hindi siya darating. Nabigyan siyang kakatok sa pintuan natin. Hindi siya darating. Hindi rin siya ibigay ni Ma'am Joyce, ni Ma'am Cherry, or ni Ma'am Michelle, or the rest of the corporate team. Ang momentum, we have to pick it up. We have to run. Bakit ano yung sabi mo, Mentor Ranel? Run. Meaning to say, tomorrow, $1,000 ako? No. Ang point ko about running is that you have to set your goals every single week, whatever achievable goal sa inyo. Kasi baka yung achievable mo is $100, $200, $500. Basta ang mindset natin, negosyante tayo. That run to build the business. Kasi wala kang negosyante na nakita na I'm working my business. Ah, ito. Ano, kumusta yung business mo? Ito, I'm working my business. Wala namang I'm working my business. Right? Kaya nga palagi, ano ba yan si Mentor Ronel? Bakit palaging run yung bibig niyan? Kasi wala kang nakitang negosyante na working the business. Pag may nakita ka na tanong ka na kumpare mo sa Ayala or saan dyan, pare, kumusta yung business mo? Ah, ito pare, marami akong nirarun na business. Diba, ganyan ang sasabihin, right? Guys, run the business and momentum will not come until you start creating it. Momentum is all about running the business every single day. No matter how small is that rank. Maybe nag-umpisa ka lang $400, nag-300, nag-200, nag-600, nag-700, nag-800, bigla naman bumagsak, nag-600. The most important thing is that you have the goal. And that will create a lasting momentum in your organization. And that will create and develop leaders and make them stay in your business in USANA. Because palaging ang sabi dito, one of my talk, di ba nung sabi, those who rest on the laurels will rest in peace in this USANA business. I've been in this business for 8 years. Crazy 8 years in doing in this business. And I am excited in the next 25 years in my career in USANA. Kasi sasabayan ko si USANA na mag 60 years yan si USANA. And by God's grace, ibigay ni Lord yan. I will not rest in doing in this business. Why? This is now my blood. This is now my passion. This is now my heart. Because alam ko, ito yung magparealize ng business ko, yung magparealize ng gusto ko na charity in the future. In those who rest in peace, those who rest in this business, yung magpahinga sa business na to. I've been in this business na nagpahinga ako dati in 2017 and it took me 2 years to get back again into the momentum. Mentor, grabe naman yan. Nakakapagod yan. Sana yung buhay namin? Guys, mayroon akong natanong isang tao sa Tahiti. Gusto ko itaga niyo to sa utak natin. Sabi niya, ano sabi doon niya? Sabi ko, you are six star diamond already. Hindi ko lang napakita yung picture ngayon kasi hinanap ko nung when we first qualified to the EDS to Tahiti. They're 6-star diamond director and sabi ko sa kanila, yung husband niya mga 75 years old and then yung bae is 65. Sabi ko, para bang sinasabi ko, you're old already. And then today, you're still doing USANA. And sabi ko sa kanila, are you not tired of doing in this business? Parang wala na kayong life? Ganyan? Alam mo, parang tinitingnan ako niya sa mata, parang sabi niya, Tutoy, bakit ganyan yung tanong mo? Ang sabi niya, you cannot be tired of helping people. Grabe talaga, and that was the defining moment. Sabi ko, bakit ko natanong yun? Grabe naman, right? That was the moment that sabi ko, grabe talaga. Kaya nga, guys, we are not in USANA because of our own lifestyle. Because if nag-USANA kami ni Mentor niya because of income, anak ko dito, asawa ko, the gift of life is a gift. And that gift is need to share. That's my definition of life. I don't know what is your definition in life, but that was my definition in life. The gift of life must share. And for me, an avenue to be in USANA, to be an associate, to be a distributor in USANA, is a gift. That nakita na natin to in the 800 plus leaders in the room, we will spread the good news in the whole Philippines. Alam naman natin anong mangyayari ng Pilipinas pag nakainom lahat ng USANA lang. Hindi naman tayo mag-ano dito, but alam natin na maging healthy ang buong Pilipinas pag makainom ng USANA. Kaya nga, in this journey in our business, grabe to guys, keep moving in this business. Don't be a victim, be a champion in every battle in your life. That is the word for the day. Be a champion in every battle in your life. Be a champion. Be a champion meaning to say, count every moment is the greatest moment in your life. That this is now the life that you have, that you are in USANA, that while other people are sleeping, you rang advance. While other people are asking question, tama ba to? You just keep moving. While other people are having detour in their life, you go where others do not. You set the standard, you set the pace, you rang advance, you change the color. So guys, thank you so much, Susana Philippines. Remember, you're always in the driver's seat. Drive your business very, very well. Because at the end of the day, pamilya, mga downline natin, mga tao natin, and the rest of the corporate, thank you so much for the opportunity to share my life and to serve all of you guys that I was able to serve to you this evening. God bless everyone.
Thank you very much, Ranel Blanco. There you have it from our Executive 5-Star Diamond Director. Can you please type in the chat box your thank you message to Ranel for sharing? Very inspiring, no? Ang dami niyang shinare sa atin, no? Not only being an effective leader, no? Ngayon may usong hashtag na tayo, hashtag change color. Ayan, gawin natin siyang uso sa USANA Philippines. Let us hashtag change color. Alright, so my key takeaways for this evening, no, very, ang dami-dami natin kailangan matutunan, pero one of the most important things na natutunan ko from our speaker this evening, no, and every time na I listen to him, I listen to his talks, very important that we get something, no, na mag-struck sa atin, na makakuha ng attention natin, and that being a leader, no, being a leader is really not, you are not born to be a leader. You are made. Sabi nga, di ba kanina, you are made to become a leader. And it's not an easy process. Lahat ng skills kailangan mong matutunan to become an effective leader, no? Allow yourself to be a part of this process of being an effective leader. Now, once you become a successful USANA associate, no, it's not only the income that you gain, but also the person you become along the way. And that is an effective leader. And once, no, katulad ni Ranel, I know, alam natin lahat na he is an effective leader. And there are a lot of our diamond directors, yung mga gold directors natin sa ating organization, no? Lahat tayo, no? Once our actions inspire others, no, to dream more, to do more, to learn more, and to become more, then that is the mark that you are already an effective leader. So that is our USANA Online Business Series this evening. Thank you very much for attending or for sharing, spending your valuable time with us, kahit isang oras lang siya. And hope marami kayong natutunan. And please watch out for more trainings in the coming weeks. Thank you very much. This is Michelle R. Canceling, your host, your sales manager from Mindanao. Good night, everyone, and have a great evening. Bye. Thank you, Ranel.